She already picked up on your name, so she knows you're here. Like, we didn't tell her.
Did she? I didn't realize that.
She did, yeah. She came up with Charles.
Chris?
Yeah?
In the casket room, I was there with the cat, and I was filming out into the hallway with my thermal camera, and I saw a flash of light at the window. It came and it disappeared. And I thought, well, maybe.
From inside? It was inside?
It was inside. I thought it was maybe a headlight. But this is a thermal camera. Headlights don't throw off heat, at least not through windows.
Oh, you saw it in the thermal?
I saw it in the thermal. And I took photographs of it, and it just got really bright. The cat was facing that closet.
Mm-hmm.
The cat got up. I went in that room and sat down. The cat got up, because whatever was in there left because I went in there. Must have went in the hallway, because the cat then followed it out the hallway and was looking at the very spot that... I have a picture of the cat looking at the wall, and I have a picture of pre-light flash, and then the flash of light that just... It came and it went. It was just...
Oh, you caught all that on the...
I took
you snaps it off. Yeah.
I will say that he gets weird, the cat. Sometimes he's always up here in the hallway whenever we're in that room.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes he'll seem like he's sensitive to something or playing with something or paying attention to something that we can't see.
Well, he was actually
I wonder about him a lot.
He's pretty cool with me being there.
Okay.
And then I went down there. I didn't say anything. And it's like the cat just got up and went and was looking right at that window. And the wind is very... You could see the window because it's completely blue because it's a lot chillier outside. And it was just a flash of spectral light.
Yeah, animals are typically more sensitive to that kind of thing. Animals and, like, children.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've heard
you know,
that.
They're more sensitive to spiritual energies. I heard something, like, I think it's somebody talking upstairs, maybe? Or...
Just now?
Yeah.
It didn't sound like upstairs.
Sound like female.
It wasn't my stomach again.
I heard it was like female voice, but I thought it was one of them upstairs, maybe.
It didn't sound like it came from up there. Not from where I'm sitting anyway.
Alright, so if you're down here with us, please, let us know you're here. We're not going to hurt you, like I said.
Should we call you Charles instead of Charlie? Are we too familiar? I don't know what you used to go by.
Oh, good point. Amy picked up Charles.
Yeah, that was what made me think of it. His mail says Charles, but I don't know what he...
Do you prefer Charles? Or Charlie or Chuck?
Chris?
Huh.
I just turned on the flashlight. There were bottles to my left, like mason jars.
All right.
I just heard them move.
Oh, yeah?
I didn't touch it. I'm far away from the table.
Come over there and see what's going on. That was me going, by the way. What, those?
Yeah.
What, they...
Kind of did that. I didn't touch it.
Yeah, you wouldn't hear the jars because they're like
There's other jars on the shelves, too. There's some jars and boxes.
Maybe one settled.
There's a bunch in that.
There are.
There's two big ones with lids that aren't secure.
Oh, you know what? I'm standing for that camera. In fact, I'm going to get back over here.
Is someone whispering in here? You'll have to speak up, please.
Just heard something again.
Yeah, this is your last chance. We're going to be leaving pretty soon. So this might be your only chance. If you have any kind of message you want to pass on to Rachel and Anton, the people that live here.
Sorry.
Oh, all right, that's you. All right.
I don't want to step on it.
Or if you want to tell us exactly what happened to you. I know they found you in here. Nobody's quite sure what happened before they found you, how you ended up in the condition you were in when they found you. Or do you not want anybody to know what happened?